me one activity. What's the first one there in your calculator? The first one.
I use water wisely.
Ah, you use water wisely. And what was your answer?
Always.
Really? Can you justify why you say you always use water wisely? Can you expand? I want to show you something today. I have here a footage of what happened during the Typhoon Sendong. Do you remember Typhoon Sendong?
Yes. Yes.
This happened in Igan. The base of this. Where the people or the victims were not able to adapt to the effects of climate change. They were victims of flooding, right? What is the culprit in this case? What causes the warming?
Carbon.
It is the what gas?
Carbon
dioxide. And this is the it causes the what we call greenhouse. And because of the global warming, we are now experiencing what we call climate change. Can you read this book here together?
In some parts of the world, changes in precipitation will lead to more severe droughts and others, an increased risk of flooding.
Now let's look at this chart. I want you to take a look at the green.
Bigger than the other gases.
Very good. Okay. So, by how much? What are the differences for the transportation that we have? Yes, there are vehicles. You mean to say motorized vehicles? What else? May I request our debaters to stay in their area? Fine. On the record, timer is. So we have there a glass where you can this is now our big topic. Okay, this is because we saw that motorized public vehicles will be routed and regulated within by Bula to minimize carbon emissions.
Good morning. We have two teams in front who will take the proposition or affirmative side to your left and the opposition or negative side to your right. Each member of the team is given a maximum of 1 minute and we shall start with the proposition. In view of the global climate phenomenon, the climate change brought about by global warming, let us consider a hypothetical situation. A barangay councilor of this barangay is proposing to help minimize the effects of global warming and climate change by regulating the flow of entry of public utility vehicles within barangay Bula.
In this situation, which is the vehicles are involved of our environmental problem, our barangay officials were proposing to prohibit the use of public vehicles and limit motors or lanes for the private vehicle owners. Therefore, I, as a concerned citizen, I favor with this solution because vehicles using fossil fuels and reduces carbon dioxide that can lead to air pollution. This is one of the reasons why we are now experiencing climate change. We can use bicycles and pedal cars instead to lessen the air pollution due to smoke from cars. If you're concerned to the people who will lose their jobs, we are sure that they will find jobs and the barangay officials will take charge of this matter. There are many jobs here at our barangay like fishing or selling products.
I am not agreeing.
the prohibition of the vehicles because since the beginning of time, it was already part of our lives. It was already part of our civilization.
I favor because public vehicles is one of the reasons why pollution occurred. So that's why I am favor to buy public vehicles. It is because having no public vehicles can keep our environment and nature clean and green. To listen street vehicle accident, to practice and use modern transportation, and no more people will get disease because of public vehicles.
I oppose your point to eventually eliminate the using of public vehicles in our barangay. I will definitely probably and strongly not be on that side. It is simply because using public vehicles like transport is a big part of our community. Why do I say so? Because normal or average people drive in a public vehicle to go to the place where they intended to go, even though it is near or in our barangay area. So it is a big, big no to stop the presence of a public vehicle in our barangay.
I support the proposal that the public vehicles need to stop here in Bula because we all know that the major cause of air pollution is vehicles. So now we want to help our Mother Earth by reducing the vehicles even only here in Bula. And I just want to remind everyone that we are the one who caused air pollution. So by stopping the vehicles here in Bula, we can help our Mother Earth.
I don't support if all the public vehicles will be gone here in Bula because not all the smoke from the public vehicles causes the pollution, and also the garbages, burning plastics, and smoke from cigarettes cause them too. The point here is we shall not focusing too much on public vehicles. Public vehicle smoke. Why not focusing on the garbages, burning plastics, and smoke from the cigarettes, which also gives a big problem to our Mother Earth, like pollution. Because if we intend to let public vehicles gone because it smokes fight against pollution. It really affects us too much, especially drivers, family, children, students, teachers, professionals, or more, who need the transportation in daily activities.
I support that we want to implement that because we want to make our community clean, safe, and earth-friendly. Our communities that are clean, safe, and earth-friendly are the communities that are aware of pollution. And there are so many ways to prevent air pollution. Just we want to prevent using gas for vehicles. Instead of gas, we will use an electrical or chargeable battery so that we can deduct the emission of carbon that are cause of air pollution. And in speaking of air pollution, it is the cause of global warming, and global warming is the cause by the way of climate change.
But it is the time to reconsider the benefits of public transportation because they definitely made our society better in many ways. First of all, forms of public transportation such as tricycles, motors, jeep are safe. On the other hand, public transportation will be operated by a specialized company or the government, and all drivers and operators are well trained to save customers' time.
I am in favor with the thought that the public vehicles in Barangay Bula will be fun. I know that all of others of you here are not in favor with this kind of activity. My concern only is that our earth is facing many problems. One of the problems is air pollution, which is very common. Smoke coming from the different vehicles are the reasons why air pollution is a really big problem. So, kahit na lang here in our barangay, we can help to save our Mother Earth, and that will be happening if we would ban or stop using our public vehicles.
I don't support you because we also know that there are many commuters that can't afford their own vehicles, right? So if public vehicles will be gone, then what they will do? Walk? That's impossible. What if they are in a hurry?
I am in favor to resolve the motorized public utility vehicles be regulated in Barangay Bula because our ancestors lived without anything new before. But why now? Because we without the sea. I know that it is good for the purpose of making picnic for the sea. But some
because if there will be no vehicles, there will be commonly difficulties on time schedules. Nowadays, some people are having a late time and it's too urgent in their work. To avoid trouble, fewer vehicles, yes. There would be less air pollution from all these vehicles' emissions. Yet, it is important to give the capability of the families that are wanting anything. Public vehicles are useful. 5.
The affirmative side will now give the side to be reviewed.
So, climate change caused by global warming that air pollution where smoke from vehicles are included. Our point is to limit the vehicles used in our barangay only on our barangay, especially the public vehicles. Therefore, private vehicles will reduce their limited boundaries of things. We can use vehicles or bicycles instead of smoking cars. If you want to go on your places, our barangay is near it all. Hospital, public market, schools, and clinics. What we are seeking for? If you are thinking about the people with no clothes, lose their jobs. There are many jobs in our place. There are jobs in ours and they have many choices. Example, our barangay is near fisher, right? They can be a fisherman. It will be good for us and to all of our lives to support the police if possible.
There is something very wrong with the city. Using bicycle or other transportation like vehicle. Can you imagine that a person who is in hurry can eventually immediately use this kind of vehicle? Why even is the person don't have a bicycle or vehicle? Don't know to use this vehicle. Why? What if he or she don't have enough money to buy this thing? Do you consider this thing?
Skin diseases, cough, asthma, etc. Where do you think that kind of diseases were came from? Public vehicles should not be banned if people are know their limitation by using public vehicles. But nowadays, many people are now hard-headed and over by using public vehicles. So that's why I'm angry by banning the public vehicles because I want to lessen the disease that we get from pollution.
First of all, it will be difficult for us to export our commodities. It will slow down the economy. The main source of our family's income, some of here has their parents are drivers. So source of income is driving. So if we remove the public vehicles, yes, we can avoid air pollution, such as bicycles, poverty. In line with that, poverty will increase. So it is important not to remove the public vehicles because that is the source of our family needs. Yes.
The drivers will not lose their job. In fact, they can change the tricycles into pedicabs and it will serve as good energy.
Using pedicabs, what if they are entering the cost of your passenger, their passahero are entering and maybe we can consider that the driver may not know how to use the passenger.
Well, many people are not agreeing because they will be late after work or they are in a rush. What is the use of bicycle? No bicycle? Then wake up early so that you won't be late to your work or on going to school.
Practically, people, specifically the students. So why do you need to ban the use of public vehicles?
If you are worried on how you could go from a far place or to school, don't be worried because you are saying that unlimited vehicles only was supposed to ride the right way. We are not saying that all of the vehicles. Why? You could pass double for 5 hours for walking.
The reason why we...
Because of the new vehicles. They cannot walk even though their house is too near.
strongly disagree, because there will be commonly difficulties on etiquette rules. Nowadays, some people are having a late time and need to be urgent in their work. To avoid trouble, fewer vehicles, yes. There would be less air pollution from all these vehicle pollution. Yet, it is important to keep the capability of the
country as a sinan to our school. You can go for 1 hour for walking or biking. You can go by walking or, if you wake up early, but if you have a rush hour, so you can use your motorcycle if you have.
Part 3. In account of the summation, the negative will summarize the presentation, the affirmative will be the last to give the summary.
We are proving our opinions, and we made sense. You wanted to forbid the use of vehicles. We contradicted. We have our point. The reason why vehicles should not be permitted is because it is one of the basic needs of the people here in Bula. It's one of their source of income, bicycles and public buses. Vehicles are part of our lives. Yes, and vehicles are also part of the major cause of climate change. Another big yes. But did you know that not all chances? Vehicles are the main reason of the gradual destruction of our planet. Let's give ourselves a dawn of realization. All of us committed something that will cause unevenness to our planet. Yes, the climate change. But it's really quite uninvisible to prevent the phenomenon since it already started. Instead of prohibiting the use of vehicles, why don't we have an agreement? Since public vehicles are public vehicles emit carbon dioxide, it's good for us to be batteries. Carbon dioxide is a raw material we can buy from. In addition, you're saying that the reason to ban the using of public vehicles are air pollution. Don't you appreciate the intelligence of people inventing the tricycle? Do you see that people are so intelligent, smart to invent this kind of vehicle that is a big help for us? So, having an intelligent mind, people must use this God-given means to think of other solutions. Problem about air pollution. So, think about it.
We are not the carbon dioxide caused by burning fossil fuels. We must stick on the goal to limit the use of vehicles. Do you want to sacrifice the safety of our Mother Earth in exchange of money? Think and choose what is more important for you.
Humans cannot survive without a pleasant environment.
Do you support?
Which side do you support? Ano? Kasi, yung kumag-hire ka ma, yun, hot, kung gadali-gadali ka. Wala, gani. Alimbawa,
you're in a hurry?
Yes. Okay. Then, if late na ka magmata, need kidney mo siya mag-report na lang good para magdali-dali.
Okay, thank you. How about there? Sorry, Ate. Which side you take? Go.
Direto kami ko.
Again? Okay.
Paano na?
Start?
O, ibala niya ang mga pag-dipigas na wala na ito niya. Wala na i-review sa sino. Wala na i-review sa atin. Parang na sa limang. Kumain. Kumain. Sila sa limang.
The more we are danger in this world. Diba naging human mo kanina na kung layo akong atuan na lugar kay madugayan dyan ta ang dalan ba niya ay mag-adjust. The vehicles, our road will be going straight. Hindi lang kita ang ating kalatanikay, pati plus maano sila ang balance time. Din sa sila madagan ang carbonos ang plants kay gagmay na lang. Paano sila makaano, paano sila makapain.
Okay, very good. Hi. Yeah, why do you support this? So you are poor, so you are the poor. That's the family,
they are, for me, it's more knowledgeable there because when we come to vehicle, we talk about rush hour, but if vehicle is always continue and kung magdaghan pa silang magdaghan, there are more possibility na magdaghan po ng carbon dioxide habang
di. Very good! Okay, you can see their point. Okay, what she's saying is that we're able to make it before, then why not now? It's like going back to the basics. Right point? Yes? How about the others?
In favor of the rural position side because we do not need to sacrifice our mother earth for our daily works like what they said. If we are in hurry, we must wake up early so that we can be late where we are going.
Thank you very much. That's a good point. Because what I think is that we can help mitigate the effect to reduce the effects of this global warming. Okay, we have a final question here. What do you think is the most significant feature of the proposal? That is the purpose. What is the feature the proposal in the proposal itself?
To save the mother.
Do you think it is fair for the barangay council to use to control the use of motorized vehicles? Why or why not?
We also save our.
Okay, so because maybe the purpose is good, huh? The aim is good. Some more? Who says it is not fair? Yes.
Ma'am, hindi siya fair, ma'am. Kung kontrol ng paggamit sa motorized vehicle, ma'am, kaya ang mga sigulang doon, ma'am, hindi man sila tatarungos na kayo sa mga tribunal, ma'am. Mga nang magbakta sila, ma'am, makukukukar ang at kami pa na
tayo. Oh, pagamit ko sila sa matay. Okay. If you were a barangay councilor, what proposal will you make to help minimize the greenhouse gas emissions?
Pagdaog, you know, stop mo niya. Bawal mo na kung stop mo.
Okay. Smoke mo. Very good. That's good. Parang if he runs for election, he will vote for him. Oh. Actually, there is a law that prohibits the law. There is a barangay ordinance or a city ordinance. But then, we have a problem with implementation. Another kagawad from this side. May gusto mo kagawad dito.
We should not sleep.
So that would be your proposal sa barangay councilor. So is it mandatory? And where would you plan to sleep? Okay, so we will find a place for that. Thank you. Now let's see it. We now proceed to the reflection. You have your journal with you. Okay, so I want you to reflect on the issue and topic you have just discussed. I want you to write your thoughts, your ideas and insights in your journal. Okay? I want you to consider the guide questions. What did you learn from the discussion today? And in your own way, how can you help minimize carbon emissions? Okay?